This is another in the first read series where I do a first reading of a poem that I don't know by a poet I don't know or know very little. And so that means I don't give it like a deep theoretical reading. I don't go back through and walk through it like I'm going to teach it. I don't try to fit it into a tradition. I just enjoy it like going to a mountain and seeing the view for the first time. I might be completely off on the readings. Sometimes I reread things and change my mind really drastically, but sometimes not. So I just read these for the joy of it. So this is what I'm doing here. This one is coming from Mortar Magazine, mortarmagazine.org. I know this wave from Donia G. Mounsef. I hope I pronounced your name right. This is kind of neat because it has a reading of it. I just listened to like the first 11 seconds just to hear the sound of it. I haven't read the poem or anything. I just think it's very cool to have in the first place. As always, when I look at a poem, I look at the form first. This one straight up jumps off as a little boxy shape. It looks like sonnet-like shape. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. All right, 12 lines. I know this way from another time, another... Okay, it's not 10 syllables, so like we're not traditional iambic pentameter lined here. That's okay. I'm just checking for forms first. I see repeating words, another, swoon, and, from, untidy, another. So another repeats, but the other lines, sand and come in. Swoon, moon, we have some rhyming going on here. Not a consistent like sonnet pattern, but that's okay. So I'm just going to go through and read this one. I know this wave from another time, another. Longitude. Well, this has got a great sound to it. I mean, just really, really lovely. Know this wave from another time, another. Love the repetition there. Longitude. The pauses with the commas in the line really help. Another sand dune, sand dial, sand sculpture. It's like nice alliteration going on here. Very nice sound. I don't even care sometimes what a poem says when it sounds so beautiful like this. I know this wave from another time. I know this wave. I feel like feels like water wave here. So another time might know this wave from another place, another sand dune. Like it's coming in. It seems similar to what you've experienced somewhere else. Sand sculpture, another isle with another swoon, another tide formed against the wishes of an unforgiving sea goddess. Waves roving from her manacious tresses. Wow, very beautiful, like this repeating wave that's from another place that you know, from another longitude, another part of the globe even, but to similar sea goddess with wishes, the unforgiving sea goddess with the wishes of it, the waves woven, covets coalesce in untidy tide lines. This wave, it's recognized. Being here, this situation, being in the same place again, but not the same place, another same feeling, the waves coming in, feeling like the tresses of the sea goddess woven, the wishes coming in with a swoon, with other images, other ideas, places you've been. I know this piece of coast from another maroon vessel, another stern post, another argot watch deck. Another hue, another fugacious view, another sulky blue between midnight and wild violet. This is so beautiful right here. I love the sulky blue idea out of here. Another hue, like knowing this piece of coast, this land, this repetition that happens with the waves coming in, but also as a human hitting other coastlines, other places, and traveling and seeing them. Similarities and the complete differences and all the memories that brings up, you know. I just go back in my own life spotting out coastlines, you know, in the US and Italy and Brazil, Greece and, you know, Sweden, all these kind of different places that similar feeling but complete difference you have when you're there. Between midnight and wild violet, shades broken by waters that sit still awaiting the return of the west of moon. Between midnight and the wild violet, shades broken by waters that sit still awaiting the return of the rest of moon. Wow, beautiful. beautiful lines here. This is great imagery in this poem. I must feel like what it says is secondary to the sound and the images, which are just stunningly beautiful. Lots of great alliteration in there, great use of the commas and the lines to chop it up and give it this kind of nice sound where it comes back and you really pull in all these different memories and ideas together. Wow, definitely want to read more by this poet. I'd love to see how it is. So it says, just a little thing, she's a Griffin Brute, Canadian Lebanese poet. All right, sweet. Definitely worth checking out some more of her work. And like I said, it has a section. I love how when magazines put the poet reading their own work in it.